Hey guys, Kyle Bascombe here. Today we're going to be talking about all things M156. All right, so today we have the W211 E63 AMG behind us. What we discussed today is also going to be applicable to the CLS63 AMG, which was based on the same chassis, the 2007 to 2011 models, and then also any M156 equipped engine from 2007 to 2015. We're going to go over a lot of the common failure items. We'll talk about ways that you can make the vehicle as reliable as possible. And we're also going to touch on some of the performance upgrades that we offer for that platform. So, now that you know what we'll be doing today, we're gonna go over to the car and get started. Okay, so M156 motor. You guys are familiar with BMWs, especially like the E46 M3s and some of the later cars. It's like everything at the bottom end of that motor needs to get replaced at some point, like the rod bearings. With these Mercedes engines, it's everything at the top. So I'm gonna take you through everything to look out for that are common failure items that every single one of these M156 engines are going to need. So we'll start at the front. You've got the belt drive and the thermostat. Those are gonna be your two common, we'll call them wear items. You've got a couple of pulleys in the system. You also have the belt and the tensioner. You wanna replace all of those at the same time. You wanna start checking the condition of all of those items at every oil change, and you're probably gonna get 50 to 60,000 miles out of your belt drive and your pulleys before you need to replace it. Thermostat is kind of going to be condition-based, so when you start to see that the engine oil is not getting up to temperature as quickly as it should, or you're noticing that the coolant temperature is not where it used to be, either higher or lower, it is safe to assume that you need a thermostat. My recommendation when you replace the thermostat, this breather hose that goes from the thermostat to the coolant reservoir, very fragile. If you breathe on it, you touch it, whatever, it's probably gonna break. Same for the reservoir. So do thermostat, breather assembly, reservoir, all at the same time. Obviously, if you've replaced it in the past, maybe just get the O-ring for the breather, throw a thermostat on there, move on with your life. We have a fantastic video for thermostat replacement in our M156 video library. In addition to the thermostat, the last thing in the front of the engine that you wanna be cognizant of is the oil filter housing. Sometimes it does leak, so you are gonna need to replace that gasket. And then look under the motor as well. Not very common, but sometimes the bed plate for the upper pan will weep a little bit. If it's weeping, don't worry about it. If it's starting to drip where it's ending up on your splash shield or something like that, you will need to drop the subframe or drop the motor and reseal it. All right, moving on to the intake manifold. This intake manifold is constructed out of magnesium. In the middle of the manifold is housed the throttle bodies, and they sit on a magnesium plate. Where the wiring harness for the throttle bodies is routed, it does corrode, and then you end up with running issues, misfires, just kind of funky behavior whenever the purge system sends the fuel vapor into the combustion chamber. So very funky running behavior. So you just wanna be aware of that. Additionally, if we're talking about the manifold in the same area, fuel injectors, there have been reports of injectors sticking and locking up motors. So every 60, 70,000 miles, throw a set of injectors at the car as cheap insurance. Lastly, when you're dealing with the intake manifold, at the back of the intake manifold sits the PCV breather assembly. So you have the diaphragm in that system. That rips, causes running issues, especially misfires and smoking at the rear tailpipe as oil gets ingested into the combustion chamber. And then sometimes you're going to be system too rich or system too lean. I believe lean more often with the PCV breather because the pipe rips. There's a, we'll call it a corrugated plastic or accordion style plastic. It rips and then you get running issues there as well. Moving away from the intake manifold, the most problematic part of the M156 engine series is probably the valve train. The camshaft adjusters, the camshafts themselves, and the hydraulic lifters, all common failure items. Lifters wear aggressively, the lobes on the camshafts wear, so that's why we have the valve cover off today, and we'll show you what wear looks like on this motor because it has it, and every single M156 is susceptible to this problem. So you're gonna see aggressive wear on the lobes, you'll see pitting on the lobes. Prior to pulling anything else, the valve train is probably gonna sound pretty noisy. So to kind of stave off that aggressive wear, you know, we do recommend frequent oil changes, getting on the liquimolly regimen, But to be quite honest with you, at the end of the day, eventually you're still going to need to replace your cams and your lifters. If you're noticing rattling noises on startup, these camshaft adjusters, they do wear out internally. So until they get filled up with oil pressure, you're gonna get a rattling noise, maybe just for a second or so at startup. The only way around that problem is either to replace the camshaft adjuster, or there's a really clever solution in the aftermarket, I believe it's from 63 Motorsports, that allows you to rebuild the camshaft adjusters. That's pretty much it for valve train. That's pretty much it for the M156 in general. You just wanna stay on top of that valve train, the manifold, and some of the items that I recommended at the front of the motor. In terms of modifications, you know, we don't offer too much in terms of performance modifications for this motor, but one thing that I did want to highlight is we do offer the rest of world, as it's commonly called, or European market air boxes for these vehicles. So the US market air boxes have this additional charcoal filter. So you have your standard air filter, then you have this charcoal filter for emissions reasons, and you have a little bit less air volume and I believe a different shape to the throat in this area. With the rest of market version, you get a little bit more volume in this plenum, throat is shaped differently, but most importantly, you don't have that charcoal filter. So that's one of the reasons why you will notice that out of market vehicles are rated slightly higher. So sometimes you'll see 514 as the figure for E63, whereas in our market, somewhere around 507. And then E63s, it was, you know, in the 400s, the mid 400s. So aside from the problems, here's what you're looking towards in terms of basic maintenance. Once a year, once every 2 years at most, make sure you're replacing the engine air filters. That way you're not getting particulate in the motor that could cause damage. Every 5,000 miles, do the oil change. Every 30,000 miles, good time to maybe do a lifter additive using one of our liquid moly products. When you're changing the oil on these motors, go that extra step, drain the oil cooler as well. That's an additional like half liter of fluid you're getting out of there. We offer the aluminum drain if you intend to drain the oil cooler, just something to be cognizant of. And then, you know, listen out for the belt drive. Take a look at the belt drive every time you're doing that oil change. And then the last thing that you want to look into in terms of periodic maintenance is ignition service. Coils are pretty resilient on this motor, but you want to be doing the spark plugs every 70,000 miles. Sometimes if you're dealing with platinum or iridium or something like that, the recommended interval is like 100,000 miles. I definitely recommend sooner than that. So every 70,000 miles, throw a set of plugs at the car. But that's about it in terms of basic maintenance for this motor. So guys, that about wraps it up on the M156 engine. As you can see, when you're dealing with a racing motor, it does require a little bit more in the way of maintenance, but I absolutely love the engine. There's nothing that touches it in terms of the sound and the power. It's just a fantastic engine. But as you can see, there's a lot at the top end that needs attention. Cry once is what I like to say. Do everything once, get it out of the way, and then you don't need to touch it for another 70,000 miles or so. If you've seen anything today that you have questions on, be sure to leave it in the comments below. Like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.